Business cards are also an effective way to network. They usually consist of logos, contact information, and a simple design. In the following lesson, we'll be creating a business card for a flower shop. To start, let's go to the File menu and select New. Type Business Card in the name box. Then for units, select inches. For the width, type 3.25. And for the height, type 2. Then set the bleed to 0.125 for all sides. When finished, click OK. To set up the boundaries in which we'll be working on our business card, select the rectangle tool, then click and drag to draw a rectangle to cover the artboard. Click the Effect menu, point to Path, and select Offset Path. In the Offset Path dialog box, type negative 0.125 in the offset box, and then click OK. Click the Object menu and select Expand Appearance. Then click on the View menu, point to Guides, and select Make Guides. Now to add graphics to our business card, let's locate and open data files flower.ai and logo.ai. Go to the File menu, select Open, go to where the data files are saved, then select both data files by holding down the Control key and clicking on both data files. When finished, click Open. To view both data files at once, go to the application bar and click on the Arrange Documents button. Then select Tile All in Grid. With the selection tool, click and drag the flower logo from the logo.ai data file to our new business card document. Then go to data file flower.ai, zoom out by right-clicking on the artboard and selecting Zoom Out. Continue until the flower is shown. Then using the selection tool, select the flower, click and drag the flower to the business card document. Since we don't need the data files anymore, let's close out of them by clicking on the Close button on each image tab. With the selection tool, hold down the Shift key and drag the corner handle of the flower to decrease its size. Then drag it to position it in the lower right corner of the business card. Next, select the logo and select a corner to drag and decrease its size. Don't forget to hold down the Shift key to maintain original proportions. Once you finish resizing, select and drag to reposition the logo in the upper left corner of the business card. Let's decrease its size a little bit more. Now we're going to add informational text to our business card. We need the Type tool to add our pretend address, email, phone number, and website. Let's start by typing Library Palmer Wing, room 4056, parentheses, LIBPW 4056, and parentheses. Hit Enter on your keyboard, then type itstraining@calstatela.edu. Then hit Enter again and type phone number 323-343-5369. Hit Enter one more time and type www.calstatela.edu/training. We're using our actual Cal State LA IT training department information, but since this is pretend, you can type in whatever information necessary for your business card. Now let's use the selection tool to select the text. Then go to the control panel and click on character. For the font, select Nueva Standard, and for the font size, set it to 12 point. To change the color of our font, go to the color panel and double click on the fill color. Let's change our RGB color to 96 for R, 58 for G, and 23 for B. Click OK to see the changes. Drag to position the text right below the logo and to the right of the blue guideline. You can also perform any last-minute touch-ups, such as resizing or text color changes in position. We can save the business card as an Illustrator file, but for practice, we're going to save it as a PDF file. Go to the File menu, select Save As, then in the Save As dialog box, select Desktop to set as the location to save our file for easy access. Then from the Save As type list, select Adobe PDF and click Save. Select Marks and Bleeds from the left pane, and under the Marks section, turn on Trim Marks, as well as Page Information. Click the Save PDF button. To preview our business card as a PDF file, go to the desktop, locate our business card file, and double-click on it to open and preview it. Here is a preview of the PDF version of our business card.